And we'll be speaking now with the former chief presidential legal counsel of former President Duterte, Attorney Sal Panelo. Attorney Panelo, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Yeah, absolutely, Carmen.
All right, so what do you make of this? Congresswoman Franz Castro filing the first ever criminal complaint against former President Rodrigo Duterte for allegedly threatening her in that SMNI interview. Your thoughts?
Well, absolutely, there is no legal basis. I think that has been filed for propaganda purposes. Number one, if there was any threat at all, was she the person being threatened? I don't remember the president saying, former president saying, Franz Castro. What I heard him say was, Franz and then you communists, I want to kill. That's what I heard.
Who was he referring to? But who was he referring to then?
The communists, all the communists.
Who was the Franz that he was referring to?
I don't know. Why don't we ask him? There are many friends. There was no mention of any family name. Moreover, Carmina, let me finish. When the former president says, you communists, I want to kill, he's just expressing an intent. He wants to. That's not a crime. An intention to commit is not a crime. He was not threatening anyone. He was, in fact, saying that the state has the right to protect itself, and the state can perform acts in accordance with law, and you have to connect that with the principle of self-defense. And the state acts through the elected officials and the appointed officials. So this intelligence funds, what he was saying is that these confidential intelligence funds are precisely being used to protect the state.
Let me just go back to what you said a while ago. You said that he was merely expressing his intent to kill. How is that not a threat, Attorney Panelo?
It's not a threat, because a threat would be, I will kill you. But if you say, I want to kill you, that's only expressing a desire.
And that desire is not a threat to your mind?
Number one, as I said, it doesn't even refer to her. So what is the basis for the complaint? You're the offended person? Maybe you feel alluded to, but the alleged offender does not refer to you. It refers to a general class of people who want to destroy the state, who want to kill the state and all its officers.
Even so, there's now a case pending. A case has been filed against the former president.
As a lawyer, I don't see any legal basis for the filing, except for the propaganda purposes.
But the former president still has to answer, right?
Well, if he receives a subpoena, then he will have to respond. Either he wants to respond or ignores it. And then the prosecutor investigating it will have to determine whether there is probable cause on the basis of the complaint filed by the complainant.
What do you make of the fact that the House of Representatives stood by Congresswoman Franz Castro?
We should ask them why. They feel that it was the representative being referred to.
We were able to speak with Congresswoman Franz Castro, I think a day after those lines were uttered by the former president in that SMNI interview. And she said, you know, the former president, in so many words, was quite intelligent in a way that he left out the last name. Was that on purpose, Attorney Panelo, for the former president to do that, so as not to make a direct connection? Go ahead.
The president, when as far as I know style, he expresses himself directly. He doesn't equivocate. He's always an equivocal. And when he says "you communists," he refers to all the communists. But if the representative feels she is a communist, that's another story. That is therefore an admission that she is one of those part of the forces that want to destroy the state, and therefore an enemy of the state. Hence, the state acting through its representatives can perform acts in accordance with law to stop them from so doing.
You can see it as that, being the former alter ego of the president as well when he was still in office. But what do you make of the possibility that the former president's followers, and there are still a lot, would take his word and follow through what he said in that interview, and therefore putting the life of the congresswoman in danger?
I don't think she's in danger. In fact, she was the one who said, assuming that she was the one being referred to, she's no longer the president. In other words, she doesn't have the power nor the wherewithal, the capacity, the resources to do it. The former president is a private citizen. Therefore, he has the freedom to express himself on matters concerning national interests.
He's not just a private citizen. He's a private citizen who was a former president.
Well, he was a former president, but the fact remains he is a private citizen now. As Representative Castro said, you are no longer the president, therefore you have no power. Necessarily, you have no power, you don't have the resources.
When was the last time that you spoke with the former president, Attorney Panalo?
The other day. Well, we didn't talk about that. We talk about other things.
Like
how he's spending his retirement, like he wants to sleep more often, he wants to just relax and play with his kids and with the upper particularly.
Because of the filing of this case by Congresswoman Franz Castro, because of that entire interview, do you think that the president, and do you think this is an advice that you'd be giving him, that he should be more circumspect about granting these interviews and saying things that might endanger other people, or even, you know, put him in a very compromising situation? Go ahead.
First, that was that interview. That was his program. He was expressing his thoughts on a matter brought to his attention. And relative to being advised as to circumspection, I do not think you need to advise him. He's a lawyer. He knows what he's doing. He's a thinking former president.
And because there's this case filed now, do you have anything, any information about the legal team that will be formed to help the former president regarding this case?
No, I do not know. As I said earlier, he can either respond if he wants to, or just ignore it and let the prosecutor determine whether there is probable cause or not. If there is none, then the prosecutor investigating can dismiss the case. If there is one, and there is no response from the former president, then he can file it in court. And that's the time the former president would have to respond.
Attorney Sal Panalo there, former Chief Presidential Legal Counsel of former President Rodrigo Duterte. Thank you so much for taking our call. Appreciate it.
Thank you.